Hey guys, thanks for stopping by. I'm Christina. I'm going from being a 10-year stay-at-home dog mom to an entrepreneur, and I want to take you along for the journey. On Mondays, we talk about this reselling business. It's just one small part of the steps I'm taking in order to develop myself, grow myself, and become all that I've wanted to be. I've recently changed the name of the channel, and I invite you to stay until the end of this video to find out why and what you can expect. All right, so as of today, I have sold 10 items. 10 items. That doesn't seem like very much, does it? But it is a beginning. It is a start. And I want to tell you exactly what this 22 days have been like, what my experience has been with selling these 10 items, and kind of what I'm expecting to happen in the future. Now, I do plan on giving you a total profit that I've made off of these 10 items, so stay with me and we'll get to that information in just a moment. Started this reselling business selling on platforms such as Mercari, Poshmark, and eBay. I did add one this week. I'm gonna tell you about that a little bit as we go along as well. Mercari is the platform that I've sold the most items on. As a matter of fact, half of my items have been sold on the Mercari platform, and I can't tell you how really surprised I was about that. For some reason in my mind, I thought that I would see the biggest sales coming from Poshmark. When I watch other resellers, their YouTube videos, and they're going over what sold this week or this month, it always seems like a smaller percentage of their sales are from Mercari than any other platform that they sell on. So when my first sale came from Mercari and I've had so many subsequent sales from Mercari, I really have been pleasantly surprised. Mercari charges about 12% fee, I believe it is, for the items that sell. It doesn't cost you anything to post them. eBay runs about the same, but Poshmark, that's 20%. I'll post a link to the video where I sold my first two items, and those two items netted a $17.37 profit. I had a pageant dress of one of my daughters listed for $50. I received an offer for $41. I made $23.86. And since that was my first item that was sold, I took that money and purchased a pair of Brooks running shoes. Now, I had gone to my local Goodwill store, and normally their shoes run anywhere from around $4 to $6, depending on the style. However, they do take shoes that they see as better and put them in a showcase, and they typically have a much higher price. These Brooks running shoes were in one of those showcases, and they were marked for $19.99, but they were having a 20% off of that particular tag's color that day, which put them around $14.99. I also received an additional discount, and that brought the total cost of those shoes to $14. I wasn't familiar with the Brooks brand, so I had to go in and do some comps, and I couldn't just do comps in one platform. I kind of needed to know how much these type of shoes were selling for across all three platforms. Did I want to list them on all three platforms, or was one better than the other? In the end, I did decide to list them across all three platforms. I listed them for $48. I received an offer almost right away on Mercari for $44 and accepted it. I was super excited about this sale because this was the first piece that I had taken money out and actually sourced myself. I had looked up comps. I had decided that I was willing to pay up for these shoes because I thought the return on them would be high enough to make it worth it, and they absolutely were. I was really, really proud of that flip. Next, I made the most surprising sale that I could have imagined. I had listed a pair of my daughter's Victoria's Secret black joggers. They're basically used sweatpants. For whatever reason, when I listed them, I put down a $25 price, which I'm not even sure where I came up with that at. I got an offer for $19 and I took it. So these joggers, these used sweatpants that sold for $19, they sold to a woman who lived in Los Angeles, California. Now, I'm not sure why you would pay $19 for a pair of sweatpants. I'm not sure why you would pay the postage priority mail from where I live in the upstate of South Carolina to Los Angeles for those joggers, but apparently she really wanted them. She gave me a great rating on them. She seemed to be very happy, so I'm glad I had them, and I'm glad she bought them. So the five items that I sold on Mercari brought me a total profit of $78.64. Now, while I didn't have the luck that I had on Mercari on my other platforms, I have in fact sold something on every platform. I made two sales on the eBay platform. One was a pair of wallflower jeans in a size 3. I also sold a pair of Arizona jeans. Now, the Arizonas I only sold for 8, the wallflowers for 12. I ended up with a 905 profit on the wallflower jeans, but just $5.59 on the Arizona jeans. But hey, that was $5.59 I didn't have before. I did finally sell a large Victoria's Secret sleep shirt for $15. They pay a flat $7.99 shipping fee when they order an item through Poshmark, so I didn't have any shipping fees associated with that. And once Poshmark's fees were removed, I ended up with a total of $9.88 profit. I tell you, I can't see anything without my readers. So I follow this YouTuber named Lindy Glenn, and while she doesn't sell clothes at this point, she sells more replenishables, makeup, supplements, but she's really excited about and hyping up the use of Facebook Marketplace. Now, this wasn't even a platform I had considered. I realized that I was using Facebook Marketplace to source some materials, so maybe people were out there looking for some things I was selling. So a couple of days ago, I took all of my listings that I had across the other three platforms and I added them to Facebook Marketplace. Now, what's really great about Facebook Marketplace is their fees are only 5%. Yeah, that's right, 5%. That's a huge difference from Poshmark. So would I rather something sell on Facebook Marketplace than Poshmark? Absolutely. You can add any listing to up to 20 different groups. So that's what I did. Whenever someone likes it, I send them a private message and just give them an offer to like her as I would on Poshmark, Mercari, or eBay. The two items that sold were an American Eagle sweatshirt and a Papaya brand women's blouse. The customers pay for shipping when they pay for their item, so between no cost of goods and no additional shipping costs on my part and 5% fees, I ended up with a total of $21.47 profit on both of those items. If you're a reseller and you're not selling on Facebook Marketplace, you need to be. Now, there is a downside to Facebook Marketplace that you should know about up front. While the seller does pay for their shipping at the time that they pay for their item, you will actually have to pay for the shipping up front. And once your item has been delivered and a 5-day period has gone by, then the funds are released. So you do want to remember to keep some money set aside to cover your shipping until you can get money back in to replace it. While on platforms like Mercari and Poshmark, the buyer is able to go in as soon as they get the item delivered to rate you, and your money is released as soon as you are rated. Facebook Marketplace works a little bit different. There is no way for the buyer to go in and rate you, so Facebook Marketplace just waits the 5 days before you get your money. Plan accordingly. But with 5% fees, I can take a little bit negative on the front end to get a much higher return on the back end. Besides the running shoes that ended up doing very well, did I take any of these profits and roll it over into new inventory? You betcha. First, I actually went through Facebook Marketplace. And I found a woman who had several items that I was interested in. So I sent her an offer to see if she would combine everything, and she accepted it. So I took $50 of my profits and I rolled it over into this lot that included a pair of tall classic black UGG boots, an Anthropologie Anticraft vegan leather backpack, and 54 pieces of higher end boys' clothing. The young boys' clothes included a lot of athletic brands, such as Nike and Adidas. So altogether, I ended up with 56 items that I paid $50 for. You can see my cost of goods were less than $1 per item. The Uggs I listed for $50 and the vegan backpack at $55. Either one of those selling pays for my lot, and everything else is just gravy. Will I sell the boots for $50? Will I sell the backpack for $55? Probably not. As of yet, I haven't received an offer for the total original price that I've put on an item. And I've been okay with that. I price these accordingly, thinking in my mind, if a customer offers me less, I want to be able to accept it. So I needed to price the items a little bit higher than I actually wanted my bottom line to be. Now, I haven't posted any of the boys' clothes yet. Those are going to go up this weekend. And I just had the boots and the backpack listed yesterday. So far, I've had a lot of likers and a couple of watchers, but I haven't made any sales. I also took $4.50 and invested them in a brand new pair of True Lynx Wear golf shoes. These were the wingtip Oxford variety. I may have changed the name of Sprinkled with Sparkle, but don't think for 1 minute that I'm not sprinkling my entire life with sparkle. I'm ready to be done with the melancholy and the being overweight and the sitting at home and not contributing anything to society or to myself. I'm ready to be better than I've ever been, and I want you to join me every Monday here as we go over what's selling and every Tuesday to find out if I've stopped swelling. That's why you've got to make sure you hit that subscribe button. Click on that bell. You'll get notified every time I post a new video.